The band's name is Buzzsaw, loud, primitive purveyors of DC voltage power tool metal. Fresh from last summer's cokin', pukin', slut-chasing world tour, on which they cemented their reputation as metal's favorite thrash, crash, and burn band. But all was not to remain rosy on 55th Street, the band's official home. First, the boys found they had been ripped off by Orte, their cocaine-dependent hairdresser. To make matters worse, manager Mike Stout had run the band's bar tab up to a level rivaling that of the national debt. Finally, there was drummer Otis Sinkrott's costly and tragic accident involving a McCullen chainsaw, his hot tub, and a born-again Christian. This pushed the band to the brink of bankruptcy.
Some people were concerned because, like, you know, me and the boys are broke because of some big bar tabs. Not all my fault, but some big bar tabs have... You gonna drink that? So, we had to come up with an idea. What could we do? So I figured, you know, sell out! Everybody else does it. We'll make some sort of Christmas music, you know? Whenever people make money to make Christmas music, everybody likes Christmas music, even metalheads. Really, are you gonna drink that drink or what? So I decided that the best thing to do is just make a Christmas album to sell out, and you can take it from there. Where's the barkeep?
The album.
Well, here's my idea, really. It's driving in my Porsche downtown on the street. Kind of. Tell those girls to wait outside. And, I must have passed out or something. And when I came to, I'd smashed through the front of Tower Records, glass all over the place. And, I was lying in the middle of the, it was in the papers, I must have read about it. And I was lying in the middle of the Andy Williams Christmas album display. I was, why couldn't it be on display? Where every bit as good as Andy Williams.
I didn't really do anything on this album. Just kind of tapped my foot and hummed a little bit. You know, Doors didn't have a bass player. Somebody like this thing.
Boys first came to me with this idea of a heavy metal Christmas album. I said to myself, what, are you crazy? What, do you think you're the new kids on the block out to make a quick buck? A quick buck? That sounded like a good idea. I got payments on the Jag. Definitely. So I decided to go for it. Just like that.
I said Frosty the Snowman was a favorite tune when I was a child. And it's a very nice song. It makes me tingly. But they made me change the words. I don't know why. It's a metal thing, I think. Percy, did you bite off my phone? Never mind!
The band pawned everything it owned, including Otis Sinkrott's drum set, fired its runny-nosed hairdresser, and managed to raise enough cash for a round of beers and a few hours in a broken-down recording studio. There they cut A Christmas Sleigh Ride.
Who's gonna do your hair now?
Have you heard that piece of crap? I mean, it's the total most sellout album I've ever seen. They would do anything to sell a few more records. Get Perry Cuomo to sing in it, maybe. It's headed straight for the cutout bin. I'm glad I left this damn band when I did. It's a total sellout. I didn't fart. I left. I still have my dignity. Get more soap?
You know, I really hate jazz.
Hey, where's my damn hairspray?
So many notes. I hate jazz. Oh, by the way, my new book should be out soon. It's called Give the Germans France.
Oh,
after the album came out.
It's not mine.
A rock and roll electric guitar.